Hey guys, John, Rocket TV One here.
Okay, y'all, this is just one more Rocket TV One unbiased review how-to video with no cuts and failures removed. So you guys get to see everything. And I will just say that I am a noob to Tracfone here. So we are going to set this up right here for you. This is the SIM kit I got there. And it has the nano, micro, and standard SIM kit in there. And for all of the United States carriers and types of service that you've had. So if you had AT&T, you take the AT&T SIM card out of here and you use that with your AT&T phone. This happens to be a Verizon phone. It's a Samsung Galaxy S5. And I want to keep this phone because I like it. Yeah, and so you guys, you may have seen the video of a couple of weeks ago where I talked about the audio on this phone, and we have remedied that situation, and maybe down the road we will talk about that and another thing. But for today, it's about how getting this from Verizon and getting it onto Tracfone. And I also am a noob at this, so you guys are going to see. I got this kit off eBay, for half price, I think, from if you go into Walmart or Walgreens or, you know, your local CVS or wherever you might buy these things. Even off of the Tracfone website, I believe they're it's $100 for this kit. On eBay, I was able to get it from Tracfone for $49.99. So we're trying it out and you guys are going to see that. What does this come with? Well, if you fold this open, I haven't even opened it up yet. It shows you all of the different SIM cards in there that this can be used with. Verizon LTE phones, T-Mobile unlocked GSM phones, and AT&T GSM phones. And that is important to what phone you're going to put this in. So as far as I'm concerned, I'm going to show you step one, and that is taking the battery out. And it is off. Yep, make sure your phone's off before you pull it back off. And, you know, you get your little fingernail in here and get that thing open and get this thing off of here. And this phone is a rooted, unlocked, bootloader unlocked, which I honestly, I'm not going to talk about that in this video because it's not for the faint of heart, and it's a whole nother story. So you can see now that I have my phone, and there is no SIM card and no SD card in the slot there. And so we are going to open this up now and find out what the hell is all in here. What kind of plastic do I... Oh, how it works. Check compatibility. We're not doing all that. We are going to be on the Tracfone website, and we are going to do everything from their webpage. Until this phone is as set up as far as we can go, and go from there. Because I do not have the there's an application that goes with this to check your minutes, and I don't have any of that set up. So you guys are seeing it here. You can see that there is a little activate button here on the web page, and so that's where we will be at as soon as we get the SIM in there. Okay, so how do I get this thing open without ripping, ruining it, wrecking it, breaking it with my fat little monkey paws? Oh, tear to open, it says. Tear to open. Yeah, okay, we'll do that. We'll do that then, I guess. Oh, of course it doesn't want to rip like it's supposed to. Of course it doesn't. Yeah, okay. Well, that's sort of another issue. You know, there's always some issue. Okay, so I got that open. And what do we see when we open this up? The SIM is enclosed. Now, just for, TV and YouTube here, just in case they have any of my personal numbers that are supposed to show up here, I'm going to figure out a way to blank that out, and so you may or may not see everything going on there. Okay, so this is the AT&T, which evidently it's a multi card, depending on what phone you have. Of course, this is for smartphone kit, and you have, it's a kit for phones and service that you have to be, have a SIM card for it. Not all phones need a SIM card, and most smartphones do. And it's about how they regulate your data usage and keep track of that so they can charge you. What's left in here? Okay, so I have a Verizon compatible card right here, which is the one I'll be using. Verizon, right here. And then the Tracfone one. I won't be using that, and it is a pretty pink one. And there's, I don't know, this big fold-out pile of terms and conditions, which y'all can read or not. But it will be with your kit. So we will be using this one. And it's got the do not bend DR SIM card. And it's got that nice gluey snot on there. Which, you know, if you have to stick something to your refrigerator, that stuff comes right in handy there. Yeah, okay. So that's what it looks like. And then, of course, I need the micro SIM card in mine, I believe, is what it is. And so, yeah. Let's see how that works. How do I get that out of there? What do I need? Some sort of clipper? Something? I am going to get some sort of cutterer to get that out of there. Yeah. Okay, so we can get all this out of the way because we don't need none of that. It's going to end up in the trash. And let me just at least get this out of here. Maybe if I got that, it would just break off, maybe. Oh, I don't know, man. Yeah, it does. Okay. So there we go. We got that out of there. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so what does come in handy there is your old SIM card. You can see this is a Verizon, my old Verizon SIM card. And just in order, because I got to imagine that these things are a bit on the fragile side, you definitely don't want to take more of it apart than necessary. So it looks like I don't really need the micro one because this has to go back in there. I need the middle-sized part, number part, I guess. And so, there does not seem to be any real good instructions upon how to get this hoodangy into a... yeah. I mean, because we certainly don't want to break it. We most definitely don't want to break it, for certain. And it looks like I need that whole thing. Now, how am I supposed to get that out of there? Without breaking it. I'll be right straight honest with you. I don't know how to get that out of there without breaking it. Okay, let's figure that out. 1 second. Okay, so I have come up with a plan to get that out of there. And first thing I'm going to do is mark the one that I need. And so I'm just going to... Yeah. Yeah, okay, so... That's not working too good. We will just place this one out of the way. And we are going to... attempt to use another one of these here without destroying it, and we'll use this as a guinea pig. Yeah, we'll use the Tracfone as a guinea pig. Yeah, that's what we'll do. Okay, so we will get this SIM card out of here. And if you look closely, there does appear to be a little on the top, so it brakes this way. Okay, so now we got that out of the way. I need my Verizon compatible card. And now I want to get this one out of here. And it already appears like it looks like it wants to fall out of there. So up there we go. A little bit of wiggling. And okay, so that come out of there pretty good. Just snaps out. And be careful with this thing. And make sure it's all together, you know, flat. And be sure that you don't try to stuff it in the SD on this phone is on top. And the SIM is on the bottom. So, and that fits right in there good. Okay, so get that one out of there because that's not the one we're using. We are using this one here. And so we want to get that out of there without breaking it. And it does appear that if you put a finger on both sides of this, it will come out towards you, just sort of like that. Just bend down on the tab there a little bit. And the little sticker should hold the micro together. And then maybe just a little bit of push down. I really would have preferred to not have my fingerprints all over that. So maybe a little rub, little rub. Yeah, it looks like most of my fingerprints are gone off of there. So you only got to make electrical contact, not optical contact. And yeah, be sure you put this in the bottom SIM slot. Okay, so I am in with my new Tracfone SIM card. Perfect. Okay, so now I can put my battery in. And until this is done, I'm not putting an SD card in here because I don't want nothing being written to nothing. After this phone gets lit up, I'm going to show you here in a second. This is booted and rooted. Rooted and booted. And it took me several hours to get this done. So I'm not discussing that in this video. Maybe down the road. Lineage OS. Bar 16. It's based on Oreo 8.01 with a custom bootloader, custom kernel. Okay, so while that does that, we now need to, best as I can tell, go up here to the website while the phone boots up. Okay, so this is trackphone.com. Okay, so this is trackphone.com, and I'm going to go over here to activate. And then it says, well, activate your device. What kind of device are you going to activate today? Well, I'm bringing my own phone, and then I click continue. Accept the terms. Oh, yeah. Cookies and whatever they're throwing at me. Of course, my machine's borking all their ads because I run Linux. Yeah. And over here it asks, do I have a SIM card? And, of course, I do. I just put that in, and so now I'm going to nail my number in. So I'm going to put in my SIM card number here in the, where it says put in your SIM card number. Be sure and get these numbers right. And then click continue. Then you have to put in your phone's IME number. IMEI number. And I have that written down over here. And so I'm gonna put that in. And then click continue. Then it asks you, is it active with another carrier? Nope, it hasn't been active with another carrier since 2016 and a half, almost 17. So I'll click no. And I do not want to keep my current phone number, because I'm currently running one of those flip phones that is still active and will be shut down. And so, of course, I can't use that number. So I am going to click no. I thought I said no. Then I'm going to enter my zip code. Now it says, do I have an airtime service plan? I do have an airtime service plan. And my airtime service plan is this card here. And I now have to scratch off my my thing with my favorite key there, which I'm going to do right now. And that is a 15-digit number. And make sure you clean that off good, because otherwise ones, sevens might be ones. Okay, so now I punch that number in right here where it says enter my service plan PIN, and I don't have a promo code. At least I don't think I do. I don't believe I had a promo code when I did that. And then click continue, because I don't have a promo code. And then it says create an account. Well, I'm not gonna do that right now, because it says skip this step right here. So I can evidently skip this step and do that later. And I'm pretty certain that when you want to make an account, all you got to do is put your phone number in. We're almost done, it says. Activation instructions. Insert your SIM card and turn your phone off and back on. Well, I don't never put a card in anything with the phone on or off at all, ever. It's always off. Whenever I did, they're electrical devices, ladies and gentlemen, so guess what? It's safer for the device and your card to do this with the phone off. So we already know that we put mine in and booted the card, and so now we are going to shut my phone off. Okay, so here's my phone. My beauty little phone. And I am hitting the button, and I am powering off. I could have done a restart, but we're not gonna. We're gonna do the power on like they tell you, and this way it finds the SIM card, supposedly. Which it probably had already done, because I had put the phone card in without it. And then I'm supposed to make a phone call. Blah, 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 blah. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. Just as a bit of a disclaimer here, my phone has been rooted and is not running stock Android software. So I do not know if they have set up my APNs or not for data and all of that stuff. I'm supposing that I'm following instructions and I'm just going to make a phone call. So I'm just going to call my mother, who may or may not answer the phone real quick, like, and we'll see. And yeah, ain't nobody on my speed net yet. And so I'll just hold this off screen real quick. I just evidently got some sort of SMS text message, which, and my phone is ringing. Mom's not going to answer. I don't even know what my phone number is yet, so.
Hi, this is the home of Jack and Janet. Sorry we missed your call. Please call again.
Well, it's evidently working, ladies and gentlemen. Hello, mother, father, John here. So I don't even know what my phone number is yet, but this is my new,
John.
Mom.
Are you on your new phone?
I am, but I'm making a video right now, and so say hello to YouTube.
Hi, YouTube.
Yep. Thanks, Mom. Yep. Okay. So look, Mom, I'm gonna call you back here after I finish this, cause I don't know. It just the dang thing just texted me something, and I don't really know what's going on. So we're gonna finish this video off and make sure I got everything set up proper. I call you back. Did it? Hey, look. Let me ask you real quick. Did it leave a number on your thing?
It did, Dad. It came up wireless call with a number that we didn't recognize, and so when
okay, well, don't say it. Don't say it here on the tape.
Okay.
I will call you back in a few minutes.
Okay. Very good. We're here. Bye,
yep.
Son.
Yep. Bye now. Okay, you guys. Just to keep from having to make a whole nother video just to finish this off. As you heard, I just talked to my mom, and I'm showing you my little network and internet settings, and it says that I've already used 669 KBs of data just for them to send me that thing. And so what am I here to show you? Mobile network. Mobile data, roaming, I got turned off, at least for now. Preferred network type. So this is what I'm here to show you. This is how this came up. This phone was completely blank, naked in this thing after all the routing and the software was installed to it. My preferred network type has got all of this here, and it says global. That was how it came up immediately. I am assuming that everything works for right now. I have not gone through here and checked all the data and all the rest of the signal stuff that is supposedly for my neighborhood here, which is, Southern New Hampshire. And so if any of that stuff is necessary, depending on where you live, you may or may not have to change some of that stuff as far as like this. Access point names. This Straight Talk was not on there before, but I don't have Straight Talk, as far as I know. This Verizon has always been with the Verizon phone. The software was custom built to run on a Galaxy S5 SMG900V. So that's why that APN is in there as that. Evidently, you can, if I click on that, hit cancel, I can get out of there. Back to that. Oh, I got it automatically set. That's why it does that like that. But if I can hit plus and add, okay? But that's not what I'm doing because at this point I don't have a problem. Yeah, okay, we know. So get out of there. Carrier settings. Is there anything in there? No. I don't talk to nobody unless I have to. Period is that. Neither does my phone. I use it for a phone and that's it. I don't need, you know, anything but my text messages. You know, if I want to see a Google map, that's it. Make a phone calls and take a couple of pictures here and there. I don't even really need it for that. So, okay, you guys, if there's any more information needed, you could see the phone works within seconds of just doing this stuff here. And I will make another part two video of whatever is necessary to get you all straightened out with this, answering any questions. Leave comments. Please rate and subscribe. And thanks for watching. John Rocket TV1 said that.